Amen.
Amen.
Tonight I want us to go to Genesis 39 verse 20.
Then Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison, a place where the king's prisoners were confined. And he was there in the prison. But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy. And he gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners who were in the prison. Whatever they did there, it was his doing. The keeper of the prison did not look into anything that was under Joseph's authority, because the Lord was with him. And whatever he did, the Lord made it prosper.
So too. Yeah.
Yes.
20. Thank you for all the people who are here. I thank you very much that any agenda of the devil is defeated. We love you very much that you have got a word tonight for them. We love you, Father, that you are in charge. We thank you that we realize, Father, something in the spirit has hit. And we bless you, Father, even tonight. As I'm going to speak, your word is on my tongue. I thank you very much that I'm going to stir up the atmosphere with your word. Hallelujah. Tonight, I want us to look at this young man called Joseph. He was arrested. And charged with a criminal offense.
And I would kill a camelato.
A charge of raping.
I would kill a camelato.
Charge of rape. So it's so horrible.
Hey,
he was arrested on a high profile crime.
Obe atswere ka molato o mogolo.
By his master. Then he was thrown into jail. But before that, we need to realize something. Hallelujah. The Bible says when he was in prison, He was thrown into prison. You know what prison means here? We know the treatment that we find in a prison. If you are a newcomer, you begin to see things happen. He was thrown into prison. But the Bible says in verse 21, but
Mara, verse 21 ere mara.
Listen, thrown into prison. But
mara.
Oh my God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thrown into prison, but
mara.
Can you hear this?
Okabase.
Thrown into prison. But the Lord was with Joseph. Right in prison there. Right in prison there. God showed him mercy. There are two ways tonight. I don't know how we are going to differentiate them. The Bible says he showed him mercy. And we want to know how. What mercy in prison is just beating one another, eating poor food. But how did mercy work there? And it says, and it gave him favor.
And ere, emu fila munyeta.
Amen.
Amen.
Good. Huh? Munyeta.
Amen.
Oh my God. That's the favor. Hey. This is trouble, man. Amen.
Amen, Murut.
I know everyone here. Favor.
Yeah, favor munyeta, munyeta.
It's like mercy.
It's falale mogao.
Amen.
Amen.
But use the word favor, please. I give you permission.
Amen.
Favor. Mercy.
Mercy.
Listen, the Bible says, give him mercy.
Bible ere mo fia morao.
In the sight of the keeper of the prison. How do you find people and you are alone given a preferential treatment? Can you say favor tonight?
Favor.
Can you say favor tonight?
Favor.
Can you say mercy?
Mercy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The title of my message tonight is this one. Uncommon favor is from God.
Favor, ye chong homodimo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Uncommon.
Favor, ye sa humanering, ito homodimo.
Glory, uncommon. Tonight I want to touch an uncommon favor.
In other
words, this favor is not common. This favor is not according to nature. It does not work according to the system of people. It doesn't operate according to the reasoning of people. That is an uncommon favor. The Bible says when he was in prison, God showed him mercy. God gave him favor. In the sight of the warden. And let's read further, you'll hear what I'm talking here. The keeper of the prison committed to Joseph sent all the prisoners.
Amen.
He committed. He gave the care of prisoners to Joseph. All the prisoners. He found prisoners there. The warden said to
him,
you are in charge. How can on earth, when you are a prisoner, be in charge of prisoners? May tonight God give you uncommon favor. Come
on.
The Lord is going to give you uncommon favor. The Lord is today.
I
prophesy uncommon favor. Uncommon favor in
Washington.
Uncommon worship and uncommon favor in the finances. Things are going to be different from today. I decree uncommon favor. Tonight, things are coming to come to turn around in another
way.
You will be asking yourself, is it me? How can that be? That is an uncommon favor. An uncommon favor will do uncommon things. Churches around this place. There is going to be an uncommon favor. I prophesy over this nation. I prophesy an uncommon economy. It doesn't work that way. But because there was an uncommon favor over yourself, it worked, my dear. The Bible says, you know, David, Joseph looked after the prisoners, and the warden was just doing other things. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In other words, what it means is, instead of Joseph being locked into the prison, he was given the keys of the prison. Hallelujah. Amen.
Oh, Jesus.
I want to see the real situation here.
Amen.
A prisoner is holding the keys of the prison. Hallelujah. Do you hear what I'm saying tonight? So he can open the door of the prison. The prison of Mutu. You are given the keys of the prison.
church.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those who take you to jail, they don't know what they are doing. They are taking you to a hotel. They are taking you to a hotel. You are the one who's going to dish out food. You just choose what to eat in jail.
Are you afraid of uncommon favor?
Uncommon favor is on your way, my girl. Whoever is listening to you tonight, since Wednesday, I never took off my jacket. Something is happening tonight. I say something is happening tonight. Something is happening tonight. Favor was upon Joseph. Those who think they pick you out so that you can suffer in prison. When favor is upon your life, you will come out.
Coming out, come on, bring your hands. Somebody bring your hands.
there inside with water, with everything. It is uncommon. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say you will not die there. My mother, you won't die there. Your dreams must come to pass. Your dream must come to pass. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, something's happening tonight. Something's happening tonight. They threw you into darkness. They threw you into the pit. And they concluded you'll never get out. I have got good news for you tonight. An uncommon favor is coming.
Uncommon favor is coming.
Oh Jesus. Ah, something is happening. Something is happening.
Yes, Lord.
I see a mother here is coming. She's coming out. I see this mother is coming out. You are coming out of the pit they have thrown you in. You are surprised why, but you are coming out. Tonight is your night with God.
It's
your night with God. Can we move on tonight? When Joseph was in charge, he was in charge. Remember, the destiny of Joseph was to be a leader. His brothers wanted to kill him. You will not die until your dream has come through. Some dreams are divine appointments of God. You will not die until you see them. You are coming out. And then while supervising, no, Joseph, while Joseph was supervising, can you see in that uncommon
favor,
something happened? Your dream will never end up in prison. I say your dream will never end up in prison. Somewhere in life you must be a leader. I want to shock you tonight. Whatever pit they throw you in, they are accelerating you to my God. I come on, they are accelerating you. They are putting accelerators. Aye, come on, amen. Come on. Look, it is the pit, it is prison. They are following one another. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whoever is putting you in there, whoever is putting you in prison, he is accelerating you towards your destiny in the name of Jesus. I'm here tonight to increase the speed. I am increasing the speed. I see the speed. Prison is an accelerator. They think it is over in the pit. They think it is over in prison. Every problem that you are encountering, it is a stepping up. Are you hearing tonight?
Amen.
Every challenge that you are encountering is a stepping stone. From the pit to the prison. Every challenge that is coming your way, it brings you nearer. Can I prophesy? You are coming nearer. Are putting you there.
cry of a cry. Rape, oh my God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was either to be rot in jail there or
starve.
With rape, there was no future. Favor will bring future where there's no future. Favor will bring light where there is darkness. When you are in darkness, you are going to see light. I prophesy light upon your life. I prophesy light upon your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Uncommon favor.
Favor is a toilet.
Can you imagine when Joseph was in prison? In the palace, the king wanted Joseph. In the palace, the king wanted Joseph. This young man was very intelligent. He was intelligent in interpreting dreams. Hallelujah. Can I prophesy you? Your talent will take you to where you are going to be. I say your gift is taking you forward. Your ability is taking you forward. The king heard that Joseph helped other prisoners to know their dreams. So he had a dream, he wanted interpretation. And he said, go and fetch him. I hear a voice, go and fetch him. Go and fetch him. There is an invitation tonight. You are coming out of prison tonight in the name of Jesus. I say you are coming out. You are coming out. Uncommon favor operates when you don't even we are not aware. To get out of jail, Joseph must pay fine. To get out of jail, Joseph must serve the sentence. When uncommon favor come upon your life, there is no protocol. There is no procedure that is going to be followed. Joseph is getting out of prison without court case, without hearing. Somebody tonight, you are getting out of the situation where you are. There is no protocol, you are just getting out. There is no procedure, you are just getting out. Favor is taking you out. Oh my God.
Yes, Lord.
You'll get out before your jail term expires. You are going to overtake. You are going to overtake. You are going to overtake.
You are going to omit certain steps. You are going to omit certain steps to become what you must become. Then he arrived at the place. He interpreted the dream. When he interpreted the dream, he was appointed. Someone with a high profile. Someone without citizenship. Not an Egyptian, no paper, no qualifications. He is hired without qualifications. He is hired without interview. He never applied. He was never shortlisted. Someone, I prophesy you tonight, you will be hired without interview. Someone is going to call you right now.
Prime Minister, he became a Prime Minister.
No more.
Yeah.
Can I see your hands? Uncommon favor, Lord.
Favor ya Australia, Mudi.
Let your uncommon favor move.
Anke favor ya Mudi me Australia.
Let your uncommon favor move.
Favor ya Mudi me Australia.
Receive uncommon favor.
Father, favor ya Australia.
Receive uncommon favor.
Father, favor ya Australia.
Hallelujah.
Oh Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh hallelujah.
Amen.
That is an uncommon favor.
Ke favor ya Australia.
Will be praying tonight.
Tora pela bushumbo.
Are you ready tonight?
Le ke mishedije na.
Something unusual is going to happen. Some of the things that I may not mention now.
Dilo tsheno nka ba ka se di bolela ka ne bya.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Things are going to happen before they happen.
While
you are thinking it will happen next week. God is going to bring, is going to change the dates. That is an uncommon favor.
Give favor and a favor else.
Something that, that needs to 2 years. Will happen in 1 month. Our God is the God of acceleration. Something that takes 10 years will happen in 1 year. Are we together tonight? That is an uncommon favor.
Give favor and a favor to Australia.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why the Bible says one person will chase thousands of people. They are going to chase 1,000 enemies.
We will change the enemy dedicated.
That is an uncommon favor. There is an area of your life where you need an uncommon favor. It's here tonight. I have given you that favor. Amen.
Amen.
I have given you that favor.
Give me that favor.
Maybe in conclusion, let me give you few examples. Those who know Hannah, the woman with who could not be pregnant. She was barren. And there is this man Elkanah who married these two wives, Benina. So this Benina bore children. That was
Benina.
But this Benina, because she was barren, she was mocking this one. Every day provoking this one. So Hannah lived in disgrace. I want you to watch the uncommon favor. When uncommon favor come upon your life, your enemies are going to be silent. They will be silent. Uncommon favor.
Favor ya Australia.
That was life in this
world.
Mocked. Despised. Titleless.
Yes.
And all those things. She was criticized. But one day, God answered. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
I say one day God answered. Uncommon favor will bring you the answer. When everybody doesn't expect it. Don't give up. Be like Hannah. Pray.
Rappel.
Go to the temple. Samuel will come.
Samuel will come.
Some of you, I prophesy, Samuel is coming. God is opening a financial womb. God is opening a womb of life. Only pray like Hannah. Samuel is coming.
Samuel, what?
Just be patient. Mark my ways. Mark my ways. The time of your disaster will come to an end.
Mm.
The
It is when you will be seen somewhere. Man of God, somewhere is coming. Someone will be born in this place. There is something that you are crying to see every day. Don't worry about those who are talking about you. God is looking at the watch. When they mock, God looks at the watch. Whatever you have, it will come to birth. Revival will come to birth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Shall we stand up, please? There are many more, but there are still many others. May the Lord bless you. Can I see your
hand?
Receive the uncommon favor.
Amen.
Receive the uncommon favor. Are you receiving the uncommon favor? Some sicknesses will be healed by the hands of Christ's doctors. The doctors will be surprised how you got healed. But it's an uncommon favor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to pray together. Before I pray with you. Point area in your life where you need uncommon
faith,
uncommon mercy, uncommon grace. I believe the Lord spoke to you. There is something to pray about. Let's sing and we'll be praying. There is an area in your life you are saying something must happen. I tried, but no. With this message, you are believing God for uncommon means. Uncommon help us. Uncommon support us. Uncommon people are coming. Uncommon time. Please pray in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray tonight. We pray tonight. We pray tonight. We pray tonight. For uncommon favor. Uncommon favor. Uncommon favor, uncommon favor. Uncommon favor tonight. Uncommon favor in this ministry. Uncommon favor in this family of Timusuma. Uncommon favor upon the audience. Uncommon favor. There is going to be an uncommon favor. It is coming. It is coming tonight. It is coming tonight. When we don't know what to do, uncommon favor will answer us.
favor.